test sourcing rule and ASL on a purchase order. So let's go into Oracle applications and test this functionality. So I'm going to go back. So in this case, I'm going to close the requisitions form. Okay. And then what I will do is go back to sourcing rules form, and here we will use the same existing setup without any alteration, and let's go and create a purchase order, and hopefully it would automatically default the pricing information, because for creating the PO you got to provide the supplier and supplier site. So what would matter there is not the sourcing rules but the ASL. Okay, so I'm gonna minimize this. Now before I go further, one more thing I would like to specify, that if at all you are generating the purchase orders automatically, then probably the ASL details what you've specified in terms of source document matters a lot. As an example, if you're importing purchase orders from an external system, and that's where the details specified in your ASL would be taken automatically by the imported PO lines, unless you have specified the line price while importing the PO lines. Okay. All right. Now let's go to purchasing, purchase orders, and then purchase orders. Hit the open button. And here I will make sure that I've got the type as standard purchase order. I will give the supplier as Allied Manufacturing. Supplier site, make sure you give the same supplier site as you have it in your ASL and sourcing rules. And then if you come down to items, you give the same item as you have in your ASL and sourcing rules assignment. Give that. And here, change the price. Let's say this time I'm going to change the price to 50. And then let's go to, okay, so as of now nothing has happened, right? The price hasn't changed. Now why it has not changed? If you go back and look at the header information, it's because the ship to is M2 and bill to is V1. So you got to have the ship to as M1 to have the price applied automatically. So I'm going to clear this record in the lines, go back to the header. I'll change the ship to as M1, Seattle Manufacturing. Okay. And I come down now. Hopefully this time we will see the difference in the pricing defaults. Look at that. The price has automatically come as 48. How it has come as 48, it's come via the approved supplier list. It has gone to the quotation, okay, this quotation 501, and then it has gone to quotation price breaks and look for where quantity 50 will match, which is here, and the associated price is 48. So if you go back to PO, that's how we got those information. If you go to the reference documents, here you would be able to see how the price was determined, and the source document type is catalog quotation, the document number, its line, and other associated details. So go to more. Let's see if at all there is anything else to see. And the last thing I wanted to show you was the supplier item, which also got defaulted automatically, but that has defaulted from what you have specified at the ASL, which is over here. So that's how the combination of ASL and sourcing rules work on a purchase order.